Morning everyone. Today we will continue with the chapter amino acid. In that part here we are going to study about catabolism of phenylalanine and tyrosine and their disorders. Yes, first we will see the structure of phenylalanine and tyrosine. So as we have studied in amino acid part 1, the classification and the structures. So, the aromatic amino acid, phenylalanine, is an aromatic amino acid having a phenyl ring in it and phenyl with alanine ring. We call it as phenylalanine. And when we come to the structure of tyrosine, phenyl ring, alanine and a hydroxyl group, or phenol ring with alanine is the structure of tyrosine. When you come about the nutritional requirement, phenylalanine is an essential amino acid and tyrosine is a non-essential amino acid. Yes. Now, so these two, phenylalanine and tyrosine, is classified under aromatic amino acid. Yeah. So aromatic amino acid containing a benzene ring is phenylalanine. The metabolic pathway of phenylalanine is through the conversion to tyrosine. Phenylalanine is converted to tyrosine. That is the main metabolic pathway. Now, tyrosine, why it is important? Tyrosine is incorporated into proteins and is involved in the synthesis of various biologically important substances such as catecholamines, thyroid hormones and melanin. Catecholamines like epinephrine, norepinephrine, dopamine. The other name of epinephrine is adrenaline, norepinephrine is noradrenaline. So, tyrosine is present in the structures of epinephrine, norepinephrine and dopamine. In that modification is done, tyrosine modification, you will get these three catecholamines. These amino acids are both glucogenic and ketogenic. During the catabolism of phenylalanine, the metabolites produced serves as a precursor for the synthesis of glucose, so it is called as glucogenic, and for the synthesis of fats and hence called as ketogenic. So phenylalanine is converted to tyrosine, and this tyrosine is very important. Why? Because it is involved in the synthesis of variety of biologically important compounds like epinephrine, norepinephrine, melanin, which is required for our skin, hair, eye, for dopamine, which is required in the CNS, norepinephrine and epinephrine, and thyroxine. So, tyrosine is the precursor for the synthesis of all these catecholamines, as well as thyroid hormone, thyroxine T3, which is synthesized in thyroid. Now we will see about the metabolism of tyrosine, that is degradative pathway. Degradative pathway, here phenylalanine undergoes hydroxylation by the enzyme hydroxylase to produce tyrosine. Tyrosine undergoes transamination to produce para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate, which undergoes oxidative decarboxylation and hydroxylation of the phenyl ring to produce homogenicitate. Homogenicitate is converted into 4-methyl acetoacetate by the cleavage of the benzene ring. 4-methyl acetoacetate undergoes isomerization to produce 4-fumaryl acetoacetate by the help of enzyme isomerase. 4-fumaryl acetoacetate undergoes hydrolysis and gets liberated into fumarate and acetoacetate. Fumarate will undergo TCA cycle or will enter the undergo TCA cycle and is a keto. So it is involved in TCA cycle as well as glycolysis. So you can call it as glucogenic, precursor for the synthesis of glucose, and acetoacetate for the fat. So it is now ketogenic also. So fumarate is an intermediate of citric acid cycle and also serves as a precursor for gluconeogenesis. Acetoacetate is a ketone body from which the fats can be synthesized. Now we will see how metabolism is taking place. In the first step, phenylalanine is converted to tyrosine. So phenylalanine conversion to tyrosine takes place by hydroxylation reaction. By the help of enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. So we can see that on the phenylalanine ring there is no hydroxy group. Now hydroxy is attached. In the second step, the tyrosine is converted to para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate. That means the amino group on the alanine, which is attached to phenol, is converted into double bond O. Okay, so you get para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate. By the help of enzyme tyrosine transaminase. Third step, where para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate is converted to homogenicitate, where oxidative decarboxylation reaction. So oxidative decarboxylation reaction and hydroxylation of the phenyl ring. That means one more OH is added, yeah, and the carbon dioxide is removed, one molecule of water is removed by the help of dioxygenase enzyme. So we get a structure called as homogenicitate. This homogenicitate will undergo ring cleavage by the help of enzyme oxidase, homogenicitate oxidase. Yeah. So the benzene ring cleavage takes place and we get 4-melanylacetoacetate. 4-melanylacetoacetate will undergo isomerization by the help of enzyme isomerase and produces 4-fumarylacetoacetate. That means the COOH group was on the right side in 4-melanylacetoacetate. In 4-fumaryl, it comes on the left side. So isomerase is the enzyme. In the next step, we are adding water. So hydrolysis, the enzyme is hydrolase. The cleavage takes place. It produces fumarate and acetoacetate. Fumarate will enter the TCA cycle and it is a precursor for gluconeogenesis. Acetoacetate for the fat synthesis. Metabolism of tyrosine. In the metabolism, we are going to study about the synthesis of melanin. So, what is melanin? Melanin is the name derived from melan, means black. It is a pigment of skin, hair and dye, or we can tell it is a pigment present in the skin, hair and dye, in eye. The synthesis of melanin occurs in melanocytes. It is a pigment producing cell. Melanocyte is a pigment producing cell. Now we will see about the synthesis of melanin. First, it is synthesized from tyrosine, or tyrosine is the precursor of melanin, we can tell. Tyrosine, by the help of enzyme tyrosinase, only one type of enzyme is used here, that is tyrosinase. Yeah, tyrosine hydroxylates, or tyrosine is hydroxylated by tyrosinase to produce 3,4-dihydroxyphenylalanine, DOPA. This DOPA, by the help of enzyme tyrosinase, will get converted into dopaquinone. Dopaquinone will undergo spontaneous reaction to produce leukodopachrome. This will be converted into 5,6-dihydroxyindole. This, by the help of enzyme tyrosinase, undergoes oxidation to produce indole 5,6-quinone. This indole-5-6 quinone will be is a site where melanochromes are formed in indole-5-6 quinone, which then undergoes polymerization to give black melanin. There is another pathway also. Dopaquin will combine with cysteine and form melanin polymer, which is red in color. Now, what are catecholamines? Catecholamines are nothing but the benzene ring with two hydroxy group. You call it as catechol. Okay, so catechols are dihydroxylated phenyl ring. The amine derivative of catechol is catecholamine. That means to the catechol you are adding an amine group, you get catecholamines. Tyrosine is the precursor for the synthesis of catecholamines, namely dopamine, norepinephrine, epinephrine. The structure of dopamine is the phenylalanine ring with two hydroxy group, where in the alanine, phenylalanine, amino group is there and two hydroxy group is there on the phenyl ring, but COO minus is not there. So dopamine, epinephrine is the same structure of dopamine, additional and OH and CH3 will be getting added up. Norepinephrine is the structure without CH3, but OH is there. So dopamine structure with an OH is norepinephrine. Now we will see the metabolism of tyrosine, that is the synthesis of catecholamines. So catecholamines are nothing but catechols and amines. Dopamine, norepinephrine and epinephrine are the catecholamines. So synthesis of these we will see now. Now here the tyrosine will undergo hydroxylation reaction and it produces dihydroxyphenylalanine, which is DOPA. DOPA is nothing but dihydroxyphenylalanine. This dihydroxyphenylalanine, by the help of decarboxylase, one molecule of carbon dioxide is removed, you will get dopamine. So if carboxyl group C carbon dioxide is removed, you will get the structure without COO minus. So you call it as dopamine. This dopamine undergoes beta hydroxylase enzyme. By the help of beta hydroxylase enzyme, it get converted into an norepinephrine, which is nothing but the dopamine structure with OH attached to the second carbon. So norepinephrine. This norepinephrine is converted to epinephrine, where one CH3 will get added up to the amino group. So the synthesis of catecholamines. Catecholamines involves DOPA, dopamine, norepinephrine and epinephrine. Tyrosine be converted to DOPA. DOPA will be converting into dopamine. Dopamine to norepinephrine and epinephrine. Now, what are the functions of these catecholamines? The norepinephrine and epinephrine regulates carbohydrate and lipid metabolism of the body. They stimulate the degradation of triacylglycerol and glycogen. They can cause an increase in blood pressure. Dopamine and norepinephrine serves as neurotransmitters in the brain and an autonomous. Now, we will start with the disorders of tyrosine metabolism. So we have seen tyrosine metabolism degradative pathway, where phenylalanine is converted to tyrosine. Tyrosine will be converted to para-hydroxy phenyl pyruvate, and that is degradative pathway. Now, if the hydroxylase enzyme is not acting or it is inhibited by some other inorganic ions, then phenylalanine will accumulate in the body, and such a condition you call it as phenylketonuria. Phenylketonuria, in short, it is represented as PKU. Due to the deficiency of hepatic enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. The cause of this is, what does this cause? The accumulation of phenylalanine in the tissues and blood. Since it is accumulating, it causes increased excretion in the urine. So, since it is more excreted in the urine, you call it as phenylketonuria. How that keto has come? The name is given due to the metabolite phenylpyruvate, which is a keto acid, which is excreted in the urine in high amount. So, phenylketonuria. So, deficiency of the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase will lead to phenylketonuria. Now, the second, tyrosinemia type 2. It is also called as Richner-Hanhart syndrome. It is due to the deficiency of enzyme tyrosine transaminase. That is in the, tyrosine, phenylalanine is converted to tyrosine. Tyrosine is converted to para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate. If this transaminase enzyme is deficient, then it will lead to a condition called as tyrosinemia type 2. Next, neonatal tyrosinemia. It occurs in step 3, where phenylalanine to tyrosine, tyrosine to para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate, para-hydroxyphenylpyruvate to homogenacetate. If this enzyme, that dioxygenase, is absent, it will lead to neonatal tyrosinemia. Fourth one, alkaptonuria. Alkaptonuria occurs at the fourth stage, blockage in the fourth stage, where homogenacetate to 4-methyl acetoacetate does not take place due to the deficiency of the enzyme oxygenase, due to the deficiency of the enzyme oxygenase, which leads to the formation or accumulation of homogenacetate in the tissues and blood, and this homogenacetate is excreted in urine. You call it as alkaptonuria. Here, on standing, homogenacetate get oxidized into quinones, that is benzoquinone acetate, which polymerizes to give black or brown color urine. So, on standing, the urine turns black or brown color. That is, urine of alkaptonuric patient resembles coke color. Next one, tyrosinemia type 1 or tyrosinosis, where the malal acetoacetate conversion to 4-fumaryl acetoacetate is blocked due to the deficiency of the enzyme isomerase. Sixth one, albinism. It is an inborn error due to the lack of synthesis of pigment melanin. Defect in tyrosinase enzyme, which is responsible for the synthesis of melanin. Hypopigmentation is a condition where there is reduced synthesis of melanin. Such a condition you call it as albinism. Now, the whole deficiency disorders we can see in one slide, where in the first step, if the hydroxylase enzyme is absent, deficient, you can lead to phenylketonuria. If the second step enzyme transaminase is absent, it will lead to tyrosinemia type 2. If the third enzyme dioxygenase is absent or deficient, it will lead to neonatal tyrosinemia. If the oxidase enzyme is deficient, it will lead to alkaptonuria. If the fifth enzyme isomerase is absent, it will lead to tyrosinemia type 1. The reference for this slides are textbook of biochemistry by U. Satyanarayan and Chakrabani.